Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the Annex Product Marketing Team, and today we're going to be looking at how template parts can be used to improve your productivity and efficiency when you're beginning new projects within Annex. When starting a new part, project, or assembly, everyone knows you select File and then New. However, there are a few important things to pay attention to when you do this next time. The first thing you should decide is what type of project you are beginning. Here at the top, there are nearly 20 different disciplines to choose from. Each of these template parts contain important prerequisites and specific part settings for optimized performance. These settings are developed for each discipline and are available out of the box to fit a wide variety of design needs. If changes are needed, these templates can still be tailored to meet specific company requirements. One important thing to pay attention to is our units. This is where we can choose if we are designing using metric or imperial systems. Next, it's time to review what template is best fit for our design needs. On the right-hand side is an important section called Properties. Here, we can once again see the template name and what units we will use, and there is also a description which provides more detail on each template. If, for example, we would like to create a drawing of one of our parts or assemblies, we can select the Drawing Template tab. Here, we can choose what relationship this will have to our existing parts and assemblies, and also select what size template we are beginning from. When opening a new template part, the application opened will match the template you select. For this drawing template, we will start in the drafting application with all necessary tools already available to use. Information such as the company-specific title block, predefined views, and other standard settings can all be defined in the template part. If I go ahead and open a new part under Routing, we can again see that this time our tools and commands match to reflect workflows common to routing. By using predefined templates, it is easy to start up a new project without spending lots of time getting set up for different design needs. In conclusion, in this video, we've discussed the importance of template parts. We began by looking at some of the simple settings we can set in our templates, such as units and relations to existing parts. After that, we explored how templates control the application that opens upon starting a new project. And finally, we finished by looking at the routing template to once again see the different commands and tools that are available across predefined templates. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.